well. Today I'm here with this video regarding everything you wanted to know about nail and eyelash extensions. So whenever a new trend comes out, I find it really hard to keep myself away from it. So I have fallen into the snares of these extensions, and let's begin with nail extensions. I live in Pune and I got it done from this salon, and they did an amazing job. The thing that I went for is a pink pastel color as the base, and what they said was splash of silver. That is exactly the term they used. So you can see the results. They were beautiful. My nails looked beautiful as coming to the cost. So I had to pay ₹2,800, which was an offer. It is usually ₹3,000 for both your hands, so it's quite expensive. Now coming to my real life experience, I adored my nails and was into them and was all praises about them until the time I came back to reality and I realized that I have to do stuff in the real world. Regarding the length of your nails, I know that this long looks good, but you should get it only if you're having your own wedding and there's a period in which you wouldn't have to do much. During the wedding period, anyway, you wouldn't be engaged in many of the household chores. So, and after that, there's honeymoon. So you get a time period in which you don't have to actually use your nails or hands much. And that would be ideal if you want to go for this length. But if you're doing it real time, you are working, you have a household where you need to do certain tasks, then I definitely not recommend you to go for this length. Go for shorter if you want to. Coming back to my experience, as soon as I came back home and I had to pull those drawers on my kitchen rack, I was devastated. You have to be extremely careful pulling out those rags because you can hurt your nails, and you can't be aware of that each time you pull out a drawer because you are doing this innumerable times a day. Also, you'll face a number of difficulties in typing on your keyboard as well as handling your phone. I don't know how many times to unlock, I had to do so many things because it won't just get unlocked with the tip of the nail. Also, you'll have super long and like seemingly strong nails, but you can't open a petty ziplock with that. Can you imagine? Because there's no strength in those tip nails. So even to open a ziplock, you have to have somebody. You can't do it on your own. So as the days went by, I was seriously regretting my decision to get these long extensions. And fortunately or unfortunately, I don't know, one of the nails broke. Yes, it broke after like 2 weeks. And let me tell you guys, it won't break in your case if you're very extra careful with it. But I was sick and tired of being extra careful. I didn't care about my nails. I just wanted to continue the daily task as I would have without those nails. So I didn't take care of them, and that is the reason maybe one broke. But I was really happy that it did, because then I went to a parlor and took the extensions off. Now you have to keep in mind that to take the extensions off, you need to pay them. It isn't much. I was charged ₹600, but still you need to pay while taking your extensions off. It's not free and you can't do it at home. So when I took the extensions off, seeing the condition of the nail that was underneath the extension, I was shocked. I didn't know that I was harming my nail bed in that way. Nail that's growing underneath your skin, that won't be affected. It's just that the nail bed that's below the extension, that will be damaged a bit. But as I mentioned, the damage is not permanent. Once new nail comes out, that will be a good sturdy nail. But still, I didn't feel like that it's worth the effort. Now coming to a point, there are some of us who do face problems while growing their nails. Their nails are so brittle that they don't grow, and unless they get extensions, they cannot grow their nail. That is like a problem for them. So for them too, I'd say that keep the length minimal so that you can go around in your daily life normally and you don't have to care about handling things, fidgeting with your mobile. Also, application of creams, lip balms, etc. Everything becomes uber tough and complex once you have those extensions. So that was my whole experience, unadulterated, for you guys. So if you ask me, no, I'm not getting a nail extension done again. I'd rather go for those nails, the fake nails that you can just stick on. They won't last long, but for an event, it's fine. And coming to eyelash extensions, oh my god, see, nails are a part of your hand, it's not a part of your face, so you don't see the effect all the time. But these eyelash lashes, oh my god, you won't need any makeup once you get them done. So I got it done from this salon and the price of it was ₹5,000, which was on offer. Generally it is higher, and here I'd recommend you guys to go for a salon which is well known, even though they may charge a bit higher, because this is an extremely sensitive case. You're dealing with your eye, which is a very sensitive area of your face, so you need to, and I can't emphasize more on this, need to go to a good place. There may be other places giving you better and lucrative deals, but ditch them. There are many stories where these things have gone wrong and the person has lost all of their eyelashes. So I got decurl lashes, which are the most curly ones, and it looked amazing. Yeah, for a few days I did look like a princess and I woke up like that. Strangely, I didn't need any makeup. Anywhere I'd go, I'd just put on some lip balm and I'd already look like I have done my makeup. Now coming to the part, if they harm your original eyelashes, no, they do not harm your original eyelashes if you are getting it done from a good place. So my beautician added like 130 lashes on each of my eyes, and each day like 4 to 5 lashes fall like your original lashes, so you can count the number of days that will last, which is not very much. So it's really expensive. You're getting those lashes only for a period like 2.5 weeks, and then you again need to refill. So my real life experience, did I face any problems in my real life? So for proper bonding of the glue, for the first 48 hours you can't wet your lashes, which was a big deal because I had to be extra careful while taking a bath, washing my face. The initial time was a challenge, but after that it's quite normal. Also, one thing to keep in mind is that once you have your lashes, please don't wear a waterproof eyeliner, waterproof anything on this area, because then you'll need to use oil-based makeup remover, which may loosen the bonds of the glue and your eyelashes will fall more. Okay, now did it feel heavy on my eyes? No, it didn't feel heavy, but you can obviously see that some extra thing is there. Like right now I can't see my eyelashes, but at that time I was able to see my eyelashes because they were so long and curly. You can see them, but it doesn't feel heavy, so that's a savior. Also, wash them and clean them properly so that you don't get an infection. I used to brush them out with a spoolie and that's it. That's all I did for care of my lashes. Will I get it done again? I would like to, since there was no side effects and like bad side effects, but the cost is too high. So that is the reason why I wouldn't get it done again. So that's all for today, guys. I hope you liked this informative video. For more content, please do subscribe and hit the notification bell, else you won't get notified whenever I post a video. See you guys soon again. Take care. Bye.